I'm going to take one leg, and I'm going to kick it back just a little bit so that the toe lines up with that back heel, okay? And this will be our staggered squat. Now, a lot of us have like more flexible hips, so if anyone wants to turn that leg out to the side, that's fine. Also, if you want to pop that heel up, the goal is to feel it more in the quads, okay? So remember that feeling, weights on the floor, let's get started.
Let's try that one more time slowly. It's called a clean and press.
about like the whole back. So even down here, this right here, yeah, that's your backside. Lots of big muscles back there, bigger weights, bigger weights. So you're gonna trade out your warm-up weight for something a little bit heavier. Remember, take a bow first. Clean double press. Start with a sweating a little bit, yeah, that's all good stuff. Because those weights are heavy enough to get you to this point. Legs are next. Legs, big muscles, big weights. It makes sense. We've got that standard squat. Now remember, you have a little freedom here. I'm going to turn that knee out. Yeah. lighter, okay? But for the most part, moderate weight will work right here. Okay. Whew. Do what you want with your legs. They can be up in the air. You can hold a bridge. I mean, honestly, really, whatever you want with your legs. But the focus is up on the chest. So if you start worrying about what your lower half is doing, put your legs down. All right. Whew. So I've got those weights right above my heart. And there's always going to be a softness to our elbow joint. Remember this? One arm. I'll get us started. Jump in when you're ready. Right arm first. Just open, close. Now let's start with your left. It is a one-arm chest fly. And yes, you're going to feel a little bit of imbalance in your body. Open, and then close. mobilize them, but you're like dead gripping. Okay, so open and close your hands. Drink some water if you haven't had any yet. So now we're gonna combine biceps and triceps in one song. So yeah, moderate to lightweight. If you've been doing this routine with me for a while and you've been holding on to like fives, you can do eights. Yes, you can. Yes, you can. And when those eights get too heavy, that's okay. Go back to your fives. But at least you went for it. Here we go.
Now we're gonna have a lunge
And we're gonna cross it over for a cross lunge, okay? So you wanna make sure that that leg makes it well past the midline of your body, because this is the target. This is the target right here. Do what you want with your weights. They can be at your sides, they can be on the floor. I've been doing one weight lately. Right leg. Take it back. The heel is up. Drop and hold. Exactly what it sounds like. Drop and hold. Drop and hold. worried. You're like, where did I do that? What did I just do for 5 minutes? Shoulders, small muscles, small weights. Not even kidding about this one. I still see greens over there. And if the greens get too heavy, which they will, put them down. Put them down. Just do your body weight. I gotta mentally prepare myself for this one. Come on, Jasmine. You got this, girl. You got this.
Two more weeks.
2 more weeks of this. Just pretend like you like it. Okay, say that out loud. Okay. The letter T. So all those little wiggle holes in rock side to side. Release the muscles around your spine. Yeah. All right, push your left leg out. Reach your right leg up. You want to grab either here or here. Gently pull that leg in. Extend your left leg out to the front room. Take your left hand, grab on the outside of your right knee, and guide this across your body twist. Meanwhile, open up your right hand and with your palm up to the ceiling. Everybody reach for the parking lot. Open up that chest. Feel the stretch run down the side of our bodies. One more inhale, gang. Roll over onto your left side, grab your shoe or your ankle or your pant leg, and then bring the heel to the tush while you point the knee away from the head. One stretch. We're going to roll up to our back. It kind of looks like the number four. You can reach through the window, either grab it behind your thigh, a little bit more intense of a stretch. Bending this top leg and hugging onto your shin. Either way, you're going to feel it here in the hip and it runs down the side of your leg. One more inhale. Alright, so push your right leg out. Extend your left leg out. You grab either here, maybe here. Gently pull it in. And once again, skin down with your hips. Straighten your right leg out. Take your right hand, grab on the outside of that left knee, and then guide your leg across your body. Twist. Now on this side, you want to open up the left hand, and then with the palm up, reach it for the dumbbell rack. One more inhale, kind of roll over onto your side. Grab your ankle, your shoe, your pant leg, whatever you grab. Heel to the tush. And then point that knee down. All right, okay, it's time to pull onto our back. Make that number four stretch happen. Grab it either here or here. We're going to bring both knees into the chest. Round the back like you're the bottom of a rocking chair. And with enough rocking and rolling, we should be able to get up to a comfortable seated position. Inhale, reach the arms up. Take your right hand, give yourself a big old pat on the back. Take that same padding hand, bring it across your body, a little shoulder stretch here. Take that same right hand, inhale, reach it up, and take it over, side stretch. Deep breath here, friends. As you exhale, sweep your body to the center, and then roll it up nice and slow down the other side, okay? Inhale, reach up, give yourself a pat on the back. Other side, what about shaking you? Shine that part out, and then exhale. orange. Green and orange. Everything else goes back on the rack. If you are doing that LT class dash, you got one more week. Come on, let's get you some LT bucks up in here. Social media hit. Use the proper hashtags and tag Lifetime. You'll get that extra buck.